please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Clearly is far from over. Earlier this evening, in fact, the governor dashed BJP, JDS and Congress's hope and picked the single largest party, that is the BJP, to form the government. And that has not gone down well, as expected, with the Congress and the JDS. First up on the show, let me tell you the five big developments that has taken place in this politically charged evening. B.S. Yeddyurappa gets to keep his date with his lucky number 17. He will be taking oath at Raj Bhavan at 9 a.m. tomorrow. The governor has given Yeddyurappa 15 days to prove his majority. Remember, they are 8 seats short of a majority number. That is the halfway mark of 113. The Congress and JDS are not taking any chances and are keeping their MLAs under lock and key. In resorts, Congress sources say the Supreme Court judgment in the Goa case is final and binding on the governor under Article 141 of the Constitution. The BJP has hit back and said the Supreme Court is clear that the Vidhan Sauda is the forum where majority will be tested. Let's first listen in to what the Congress spokesperson Surjewala is saying.
A post-poll coalition, and how did the governor permit you then to form the government superseding the Congress party, which had the single largest majority? We want to ask you, Shri Amit Shah, if two parties cannot come together in a post-poll coalition and form a government, then how did you form a government in the state of Meghalaya when BJP had only two legislators, Congress had 21 legislators and was the single largest party, and BJP had fought against NPEP, UDP, PDF, and HSD-PDP, the four political parties? How did you form a post-poll coalition and then form a jointly a government superseding the single largest party? If two parties can't come together in a post-poll coalition, as BJP now claims, our question to you, Shri Amit Shah, and to Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi is, then how did you form a government in Manipur, where Congress was the single largest party with 28 legislators, and BJP was a distant second with 21 legislators? How did you form a post-poll coalition and the single largest party, Congress party, was superseded for formation of a government? The truth, my friends, is that Shri Amit Shah and Shri Narendra Modi today sanctioned encounter of the Constitution, encounter of the law, an encounter of all settled precedents, permitting a post-poll coalition to form the government at the instance of Governor of Karnataka, Shri Vajubhai Vala. Governor has shamed the office of the governor. Governor has trampled upon the Constitution. Governor has subjugated the law. Governor has negated all the precedents. And I don't think so. Such a person has right, moral or constitutional, even for a day to continue to hold the office.
A strong attack coming there from the Congress party against the governor of Karnataka, who has invited B.S. Yeddyurappa, who will be sworn in as the chief minister tomorrow. So 75-year-old B.S. Yeddyurappa will be, in fact, keeping his date with the number 17. The BJP, though, plans to keep it a low-key affair. The oath ceremony is likely to be symbolic. Let's get a quick update from Bengaluru. Joining us live, Stacey is joining us from outside Raj Bhavan. Deepa is from the Congress office. And in fact, we also have Revati, who is joining us from Eagleton, where all the Congress MLAs have been kept there so that there cannot be any poaching. Deepa, I'm coming to you. Finally, the call has been made on BSY, B.S. Yeddyurappa, will be sworn in tomorrow. He had asked for 7 days, Deepa. He has been given 15 days to prove his majority. What is the ceremony going to be like? Will Amit Shah and Prime Minister be travelling for this? And how many ministers will be sworn in tomorrow?
Well, in all likelihood, a very low-key affair, though a couple of BJP MLAs have actually tweeted out seeking public support, saying that the people must come together for this celebration of the BJP taking oath of office. In
fix that audio with you. Let me quickly get in Stacey. Stacey, you know, the BJP in its defense says that the S.R. Bommai judgment of 1994 is very clear that the governor has to invite the leader of the party, which single largest party. They're also saying that Sarkaria Commission 1998 also says the same, that the leader of the single largest party must be invited. The Congress also says that they have enough and more precedents to say that the governor is working right now as the stooge of the BJP. What is the governor's defense? We were told that through the day he held a number of meetings and talks with several legal luminaries. He also dialed the former Attorney General Mukul Rohatgi.
That's right. That's what the governor did. He did keep everyone guessing right till the very end, and which is when we saw this letter that finally came out, before which there was already celebrations probably at the BJP office, where you saw them put out tweets saying that, yes, it will be B.S. Yeddyurappa taking the oath as the chief minister tomorrow. But what the governor has done, like you mentioned, the Bommai case, what the BJP are claiming is, you know, what is right and what, which is why they have been invited to form the government. Whereas you have the Congress and the JDS, the coalition there, who are going to use perhaps, you know, the instances of Manipur and Goa, which the BJP did to form the governments in those states. So you're going to see both these play out. We also know that both Congress and JDS said that, you know, if they are not invited, they are going to look at the legal route. So things from just, you know, it's just the starting of things, one can say, perhaps, because we are definitely, they're not going to just be mute spectators. We are probably going to see the legal route being taken now that we know that it's official that the invite has come from Governor Vajubhai Vala to B.S. Yeddyurappa, and he will indeed swear in as Chief Minister tomorrow at 9 o'clock here at Raj Bhavan.
Okay, let me bring in Revathi now. Revathi, the Congress party is saying, in fact, senior party leaders have said that the judgment in the Goa case dated 14-3-2017 is the last and final declaration of law. It is binding on the governor under Article 141 of the Constitution. Are they preparing to approach the court tonight itself?
Well, the Congress has not officially made that clear to us at this point, but they did mention in more than one way that they are looking at all the possibilities of tackling this at this point constitutionally and legally. And each of these MLAs we've been speaking to, who has gone inside the Eagleton Resort at this point, said that they are under a political compulsion to come together, under a political compulsion to also stay together at this point, and that the constitutional representative has not acted according to the provisions of the Constitution. So they will have to really act quick at this point to ensure that their MLAs don't switch sides on one side, and secondly, to get in a favorable sort of response, whether they move constitutionally and legally as well. At this point, the governor's office clearly said that Yeddyurappa has 15 days time to prove his majority. Now, that is a long time as far as the parties are concerned, for both the JDS and the Congress, who have claimed that BJP has approached several of his MLAs. So if it's just 5 or 6 days too, that is a long time, and it's 15 days time, which means that we'll be expecting more drama and more of the resort politics at this point.
Yes, let me bring in Deepa. Deepa, you know, B.S. Yeddyurappa had asked for 7 days, and what he got from the governor is 15 days to prove his majority. The question that I'd asked earlier, what is going to be the ceremony like tomorrow, and will senior party leaders from Delhi be travelling as well, and how many ministers will be sewn in?
B.S. Yeddyurappa is likely to be the only person who is taking oath of office tomorrow at the Raj Bhavan. It's going to be a pretty low-key affair inside the Raj Bhavan. Though the a couple of the BJP MLAs have actually, you know, asked for public support, asked people to gather in large numbers for the celebration. I really doubt that is going to happen outside the Rajbhavan itself. Inside Rajbhavan, it will be pretty muted with selective guests who are allowed inside, and Yeddyurappa himself taking oath of office, and not with any other cabinet ministers per se. Neither the national president of the BJP, Amit Shah, nor Prime Minister Modi are expected to be travelling for this. Hmm. But yes, you made an interesting point about the 7 days being sought. 7 days' time is what Yeddyurappa had sought from the governor to prove his majority on the floor of the House, where the best test of a majority can be done. How is it that the governor has actually given him 15 days? That has already raised suspicions and doubts within the Congress about the governor's bias for two reasons. One is that usually when somebody comes out and asks for a particular time frame to actually prove his majority in the floor of the House, either he is given 48 hours or 72 hours. At the most, he is given a week. This is what one of the Congress spokespersons who has been part of the strategy for the Karnataka campaign was telling us just a short while ago. 15 days is really unheard of. So is he really giving more time and more of a leeway for the Congress now, for the BJP now, sorry, to actually allow poaching or horse trading from other parties? You know, that's one big concern for both Congress and the JDS. Second, of course, they are citing a 2006 Supreme Court judgment in this regard, saying that the governor cannot refuse permission where a coalition of parties has actually, enough numbers to have a simple majority and perhaps a little more, and that should be given the priority as far as government formation is concerned. There's a Supreme Court judgment of 2006 in a case, and they are saying that this is their best argument in their defense.
All right, Deepa Balakrishnan, Stacey and Revathi, thanks so much for joining us. This remains our top focus. Tomorrow is the day where B.S. Yeddyurappa will be sewn in as the chief minister. It will be a low-key affair. Just he inside Raj Bhavan, who will be taking oath to office. He has been given 15 days to prove his majority. The Congress is saying that the governor is acting like a karyakarta of the BJP. He's acting as a stooge of the BJP.